This conference will now be recorded.
Good morning, all of you. So yesterday we were discussing regarding the abbreviated NEURAL application. So briefly, we'll just revise it once again. So why it is called as abbreviated? So we have come across this investigational NEURAL application, NEURAL application, and abbreviated NEURAL application. And as we discussed yesterday, the abbreviated NEURAL application is where we don't have to submit all the information regarding the new drug or new chemical entity. We need to have to especially submit upon along with the application, we have to submit the bioequivalent studies. We don't have to submit all the preclinical studies. We have to submit to the CDA, especially this ANDA, abbreviated new drug application, is elaborately explained. Or the procedures are very versed in this thing in US FDA. So if we search the abbreviated new drug application in other countries like India or Europe, it is not as much as explained as it is in US FDA. And also these countries, these majority of the other countries follows this pattern of ANDA application that is done, that is however it is, how it is practiced in US. So we are learning how the ANDA application is done in US by the, like, what are the guidelines prescribed by the US FDA. So ANDA is submitted to the CDER, Central Drug Evaluation and Research. The FDA CDER, it is submitted to the FDA CDER, and the data that is submitted is mainly the bioequivalent studies, and these bioequivalent studies requires around 30 to 34 healthy volunteers, and to whom we give the particular generic version, and we will see how it is like we'll compare with the brand name, with the brand drug. So this brand drug has to be already like it should be approved, or it should be listed in the Orange Book. So we discussed what is Orange Book yesterday. Orange Book is it is a book where all the approved drugs are listed in the or the approved drug by the US FDA are listed. So these are all these drugs are present in the Orange Book, and each of the drugs has got a reference number. That is why we call the brand drug as a reference. So reference listed. So whenever we submit the application, we have to always mention about the reference drug. Reference drug is the particular brand drug for which we are going to manufacture the generic version. So that reference listed drug has to be mentioned, or that reference number or the reference listed drug has to be mentioned. It is also called as the innovator drug, brand name drug. Or innovator drug, or the reference listed drug. So it is we are preparing the generic drug. Reference listed drug, or it is otherwise called as the brand name of the innovator drug. So this has to be present in the Orange Book. So when we submit the ANDA application, we are also mentioning like for which drug we are going to prepare the generic version. Then the requirements, the active ingredient has to be same, route of administration, dosage form, strength, indication. Should be the same. Inactive ingredient should be already present in the, like, it should be in use. Then the objective also we discussed to reduce the price, to reduce the time of development and the bioavailability. Then these are the like comparison of the innovator or the reference drug and the generic version. Then what is the like difference between a new drug application and the abbreviated new drug application? Then how it all started, because of this particular the act, like which is called as the Drug Price Competition and Patent Term Restoration Act of 1984. So that which is also called as the Hatch-Waxman. This act, because of this act, like they were able to, like it is now able, like it is now possible to bring out the generic version of the drug without doing all the studies again. So this particular act is the one that expedited the approval of the generic version of the drug, so that it will be available to the public. The cost effective or less expensive generic version is available to the public at an earlier stage. So it is all because of this particular act. So this act permit, it will permit the FDA to approve the generic versions without going through all the preclinical studies and clinical studies again. Then some of the information that we need to submit along with the ANDA application. Today we'll see in more detail what all has to be submitted when we are filing an ANDA. So we'll start with the format and content of ANDA. So there is something called as ICH, International Conference on Harmonization. So ICH, which is a very, it is an international organization, which includes, it was started with certain countries such as US, Japan, and Europe. And why it started, this particular ICH started, because we know that the guidelines in various countries regarding to the, like in regard to the research is not uniform. So basically we all the countries, they do research on human beings, but the guidelines in each of these countries were different. So ICH or International Conference on Harmonization, their main objective is to prepare something uniform, some uniform guidelines which can be a little modified according to the country, and they can use it. So that the research will happen in every country, but the basic standards of the research will be met. All the basic requirements for clinical research in human beings can be met in all the countries. So that was the intention behind the formation of International Conference of Harmonization. The three main countries which joined together to form these particular organizations, the Europe, US, and Japan. Now many other countries are also part of it. So the main intention behind this ICH or International Conference of Harmonization is that the research, all the basic requirements of the research is met when it is done in all the different countries. And also another advantage is that if a particular drug is approved in the US after if it has to be approved in the US, it has to be done in accordance with the guidelines in the research guidelines in the US. So once a particular drug is being approved in the US, if it requires to be marketed in other countries such as Europe, we know that now pharma companies are like, it is we are exporting drugs to other countries. It is a global market. So if a particular country brings marketing approval of any drug, it can be, it should be able to, we have to find the market in other countries also. But if the research is not taken place in if the research has not happened up to the standard, then it is a problem. So in order to avoid, one reason for the ICH is that if the guidelines are uniform across the countries, if a particular drug is manufactured in a country, it can be again can be manufactured in other countries also, because the guidelines are similar. So that is to bring out a similar guidelines in all the countries, these ICH came into being. And even though the ICH is there and the ICH guidelines are being followed by all the countries, even some other rules are also there. If we want to market a drug that is approved in the US, in India, we have to, like they have to do, again, some application has to be built and some minor hurdles are there. But still, we can say that if the particular country follows the ICH guidelines for research, then we can say that they have done it according to the guideline and it is going to be a safe and effective medication. So any country can go forward with marketing the particular drug after maybe a few hurdles. Otherwise, again, right from the preclinical, or all the clinical steps has to be repeated in the country they are going to market the drug again. So to avoid that, we have this ICH, or International Conference of Harmonization. So that is the main intention behind this formation of International Conference of Harmonization. And we'll come back to ANDA. For ANDA also, the International Conference of Harmonization has brought a common technical document. So the FDA also recommends this ICH common technical document for filing the abbreviated new drug application. So this ICH common technical document has got 5 modules. So in these 5 modules, like they have to submit the data according to what is being described in this 5 modules. For example, the module 1, we have to provide the administrative and prescribing information according to the region. Then in module 2, we need to submit all the summaries and overview of the modules in 3, 4, and 5. So module 1 is administrative and prescribing information, region specific. Module 2 is summaries and overview of what we are going to submit through module 3, 4, and 5. So module 2 is something about like summary and overview of module 3, 4, and 5 separately. Then module 3, we have to submit the information on product quality. Then module 4, non-clinical study reports. This non-clinical study report is not applicable to ANDA. Then module 5 contains the clinical study reports. So this is the CTD, or common technical document, that is recommended by the ICH, and that is being followed in the US FDA. Majority of the nations also follow this particular ANDA, like this particular document, to file abbreviated new drug application. So there are 5 modules, and each module has got different information that has to be submitted. So we can see what is exactly in module 1. So in module 1, little bit dry portion. You just have to remember the headings and few points. So this is how we have to submit the ANDA document. So in module 1, we can see that administrative and prescribing information. So they have to, all the documents should be organized in a particular order in the module 1. So first comes the forms and cover letter. So for the ANDA, there is a form called as FDA Form 356H. Then they have to also submit a cover letter, then a form FDA 3674. So these are the forms and cover letter that has to be submitted. So this has to be like in any other application form, it has to be completed. The form has to be filled and it should be completed, and it should be properly signed by the agent who is going to submit it. So first comes the forms and cover letter. Then table of content. Table of content means like what all are included in the particular module. Like it is, all these modules are separate documents. So in module 1, what are all the contents? So a comprehensive table of content has to be included. So there will be volumes, then page number of the contents, etc. And what all has to be included in this particular module 1 is prescribed in the 21 CFR 314. So sometimes like 42 mark questions they'll ask what is CFR. CFR is Code of Federal Regulation. So this Code of Federal Regulation is it comes, the CFR contains all the rules like regarding the food, drug and other commodities that are marketed in the US. So section 21 of Code of Federal Regulation. So Code of Federal Regulation is a regulation that is being practiced in the US, and it has this regulation pertains to all the commodities we can see that is marketed in the US. The 21, section 21 of the Code of Federal Regulation contains most of the regulations that is related to the food and drugs. So in this 21 CFR at all will be asked for 2 marks. So there is something called as Code of Federal Regulation, and it will be having regulations or rules pertaining to all the commodities we can see in the US. And the 21 section 21 of the Code of Federal Regulation has got the information or the regulations, most of the regulations pertaining to food and drug. So that is why it is mentioned 21 CFR. So in section 21 of Code of Federal Regulation will be including most of the regulations pertaining to the food and drug. So, and 21 CFR 314. So in 314, we can see all the applications for the FDA approval to market a new drug. So in 314, there will be different parts like 314, 1, 2, 3. So similarly, as it comes to 314.94, we can see the ANDA module contents. It can be found in 21 CFR 314.94. So similarly, 21 CFR 320 will be containing all the bioavailability and bioequivalence requirements. So we need to remember these certain sections in the what is given in the Code of Federal Regulation. It is usually asked for 2 marks question. So there is a Code of Federal Regulation, and section 21 of Code of Federal Regulation contains all the regulations pertaining to food and drug. Then 21 CFR part 314 will be containing all the applications for FDA approval to market new drug. And we can see part 320, we can see the bioavailability and bioequivalence requirements also. So here we can see module one, we need to also include a comprehensive table of content, and what all has to be included in the module one table of content, or inside what has to be included, it will be, we can find it in the Code of Federal Regulation 21 CFR part 314.94. So there you can find the entire table of content or index that has to be submitted for the module one. Then next comes the administrative documents. So all these also, the administrative documents that has to be submitted also is mentioned in the 21 CFR part 314. So with those details, we can whoever is going to submit, they can refer the 21 CFR part 314 to see what all administrative documents that has to be attached. Then in module one itself, again we need to also include the prescribing information. So all the copies of labels and all labeling for the product should be included. So such as what all can be included: container and package label, then package insert, then draft labeling, what all patient leaflets, any information sheet is there, any other medication guide is there. All those information can be, like example, any of these can be included along with the, as a part of the prescribing information. So first we need to submit the in module one, mainly it requires, in module one we have to submit the administrative and prescribing information, and in that comes the forms and cover letter. So these forms are available online. Even ECTD forms are there, electronic form and technical document. So these forms are available online. So the forms, the names of the forms are mentioned, and along with that, a cover letter should be there. Then comprehensive table of contents should be there, and what all has to be included. It is mentioned in the 21 CFR Code of Federal Regulation Part 314. Then we can see the administrative documents also. We can refer the 21 CFR part 314. Then the prescribed information such as the labeling container and pack, what all labels they are going to give along with the, or whatever has been given along with the brand product, that can be submitted. Draft labeling, patient information, patient leaflet, etc. Then labeling comparison. So again, it is mentioned in 21 CFR part 314. Labeling comparison is the comparison of label that is intended to be used for this particular generic version, and it will be compared along with the label that is already available for, like, for which marketed drug we are going to prepare the generic version. So that particular brand drugs label has to be like also to be submitted, and they'll compare both these labels. The idea is that both has to be similar, because when we say about the generic version, the generic drug is a copy of the generic drug product is a copy. It should be comparable to the innovative drug product in every way: dosage, form, strength, route of administration, quality, performance, the characteristics that also even the intended use. So the label has to be similar. So that is what they are going to check. So labeling comparison is there. So labeling comparison also has to be submitted, and for this also we can refer the 21 CFR 314. Then comes the module 2. So module 2, as we discussed earlier, the module 2 contains all the document summaries. So all the document summaries that is of module 3, the summaries of module 3, 4 and 5. So you can see here we have to submit all the list, all the documents that are submitted in module 3, 4, 5, and a summary of that has to be submitted. And we also have to submit the introduction to the summary documents. For every summary document, an introduction has to be given, and this introduction can be on how to prepare this. We can get the guidance from the guidance document M4 or message to the CTD. So the CTD or the ICH already has described like how it has to be submitted. So based upon that, we can prepare the introduction to the summary documents. So what all are included in overviews and summaries? So all the additional documents, such as we can see that module 3 corresponds to quality. So all the like summary, what all overall quality summary, quality documents are there, a summary of that has to be included in module 2. Then non-clinical overview, since ANDA, we don't have to submit the non-clinical data, we don't have to submit this. Then clinical overview, then clinical summary, all these are some of the documents that are submitted along with module 3, 4, 5. So the summary of that has to be included in the module 2. So summary as well as introduction to the summary documents has to be included when we submit the module 2. So module 3 corresponds to quality. So in module 3, we need to submit all the information that is pertaining to the quality of the particular product. So here also the guidance document can be followed. So CTD quality guide M4Q gives the information on what all things has to be submitted for module 3. So this can be referred, and all the headings that are provided in the CTD quality or M4Q can be used. And so there should be a table of content, and the content is mentioned in the CTD quality, so that can be used. And the body of data, then whatever is being submitted, we need to if it is a different document, then it should be bound separately, or some identifier should be there that which helps them to identify that this is the next part is a separate document. So when the modules are being submitted, like the individual subsection has to be differentiated or it should be bound separately. Then the literature references also has to be provided along with the document, and this particular reference has to be separated from others by again tab identifiers. So it should be separated and it should be given separately, or there should be some identifiers which helps them to understand that the coming document is a separate document. So that is That is module 3. Module 3 specifically, like it, we have to submit information regarding the quality. So we, so that is what we need to submit for module 3. Then module 4. Module 4, non-clinical, module 4 is non-clinical study reports, but for an ANDS, we discussed earlier, abbreviated new drug application, module 4 is not necessary because non-clinical data is not required. What mainly we require is the bioequivalent data, and the bioequivalent study can be done in healthy volunteers, like 24, around 24 to 36 healthy volunteers are selected, and we give them the particular generic as well as the brand product, and the rate and extent of absorption can be determined in these group of healthy volunteers, and we compare it. So if the time taken by generic drug to reach the blood is, if it is same as at the brand, then we can very well say that it is bioequivalent, or the bioequivalency is same. So it can be the generic version is comparable version of the brand one. So here we are not using any animal studies, so we don't have to submit any non-clinical study reports for ANDA submission. So module 4 is not applicable in case of ANDA, abbreviated new drug application submission. Then module 5, we have to submit the clinical study reports. So all the clinical study reports and related information. So here we need to mainly focus on the all the clinical study reports of that is available, or that all the study reports of the brand drug has to be given along with the bioequivalent studies that is done in the healthy volunteers. So these has to be submitted in the clinical study report, which is the module 5. So module 5 also should have this table of contents. So all the modules, if you see, they have this table of contents. Then this table of contents, like what all has to be included in the module, that is also again given in the M4E of CTD efficacy. So in if you module 4, we can see that it is not clinical study report, it is not required. Then module 3, it is the quality. So module 3 corresponds to quality. So there is, that is called as MQ, M4Q. So here it is M4E, the CTD or the technical document, common technical document. We can see we have to refer to this M4E, which is saying about the efficacy. So that particular guidance has to be referred, and all the section headings and all we can find out from the CTD efficacy or M4E. Then here also each of the documents, study reports and related information, has to be given separately, or if it is a separate document, then appropriate identifiers should be there so that they can understand. Then again, literature references also has to be attached, and these literature references also should be separated from others with the help of this tab identifiers. So in when this particular module is quite important, where we need to also submit the bioavailability bioequivalence data. So we need to prove that our particular generic version is as like equally as efficacious as our brand version. So we need to submit all the clinical study reports in the module 5, and we can also refer to the ANDA filling checklist, so that we can ensure that whether the all the aspects of ANDA is all the aspects are included when we submit the module 5. So we can check with the help of ANDA filing checklist. So all these resources are available online, so they can refer to it and they can include these all the necessary information and file the ANDA. So to whom we file the ANDA? In US, we are filing the ANDA to the Center for Drug Evaluation and Research, CDER, Office of Generic Drugs. So we need to submit it to them, the Center for drug evaluation, FDA's Center for Drug Evaluation and Research. Then how many copies we need to submit? So module 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and how many copies we have to submit? So we have to submit the archival copy, review copy, and also field copy. So archival copy is the complete copy of the application, like from right from the module 1 to 5, we have to submit. So that is the archival copy. So it will be archived in the official website for the every ANDA submission folder they will be having. So in that it will be archived. The complete copy of the application will be there. Then review copy is there where we need to divide it and submit. So according to like each review discipline will be there, like there will be a discipline which will be reviewing the quality, which will be reviewing the clinical. So according to the discipline, review discipline, we need to segregate and submit. So so we have to like if this particular the module 1 and 2 should be it should be there in all the copies. For module 3, 4 and 5, we need to separately attach and submit. For example, if we are going to submit to the review discipline of quality, so we need to submit module 1, 2 and 3. So 3 is module 3 is corresponding to the quality. Similarly, if you want to submit, like all these we need to submit, if we are submitting to the review discipline of clinical, then we need to submit copy of module 1, 2 and module 5. You don't have to submit 2 and 3, 3 there, 3 or 4 there. Then, that is how each review copy should be labeled and bound separately. So there is, so 3 copies are there. There is archival copy, review copy and field copy. Archival copy is the complete. All the modules along with the covering letter, everything has to be there. Module 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 should be there in archival copy. In review copy, module 1 and 2 is mandatory, and along with that, to whichever review discipline we are submitting, that module alone we have to attach. So module 1 and 2 along with the particular review or specific review discipline to which we are going to submit. For example, in case of if we are submitting the quality, we need to submit module 1, 2 and 3. If you're submitting the clinical, then we have to submit module 1, 2 and 5. So that is how it should be done. Then also we need to submit a field copy field copy also we need to submit, and this field copy should contain only that module 3. So module 3 alone can be submitted as a field copy. So these are the number of copies that has to be made and submitted. So mainly 3 copies, and these 3 copies also varies according to the content. Only the archived copy will be having the full entire document. Other review copy, for example, review copy will be containing only the quality section, and the review copy, like pertaining to the particular review discipline to which we are submitting, only that that module along with the module 1 and 2 will be submitted. Then the color, some binder colors for the ANDA copies. So the archival copy we have to follow, it should be blue. Review copy should be red and field copy should be green. So that is the ANDA format and content. So ANDA format and content, we can see that they follows the ICH. The US FDA follows the ICH. ICH is International Conference of Harmonization. It's an international organization which helps to harmonize the various guidelines that is in different countries, so that the research will be of standard quality in each of the countries. So they have, the ICH has recommended CTD or Common Technical Document. So for filing the ANDA, and FDA follows that particular the same common technical document, and we can see that it has to be submitted. The common technical document has got different parts, and there are different documents which is required, and these documents they have divided into different modules. As we can see in module 1, it is the administrative and prescribing information, and then module 2, summaries and overview. Summaries and overview of whatever is coming in, module 3, 4 and 5. Then module 3 is information on the product quality. So in module 3 especially, we can see like they have to submit the information on the chemistry or the microbiology data, then pharmacy and toxicology data, then like the stability of the product, then whether like whether it was done according to a good manufacturing practice. So all those are information that is that has to be included in the module 3. So information on the product quality. Then module 4, non-clinical study reports, that is not required for ANDA. Then module 5 is the clinical study reports. Then for all these modules, there are also we are having several guidance documents, which is or certain guidance resources. The whoever is going to submit, they can refer to these guidance resources and they can fill the forms. So module 1, administrative and prescribing. So some of the information is given in the 21 CFR or section 21 of Code of Federal Regulation. So these information, data can be accessed and we can refer to that and fill the document. Then prescribing information, all the prescribing and administrative information comes in the module 1, and also the labeling comparison. So labeling comparison is, we have the intended or the label that we are going, supposed if we get approval, what label that we are going to use for generic version, that has to be submitted. And also the existing label for the brand product also needs to be submitted. So whenever they compare the label, they will see that this is similar, or because since we know that the generic version is comparable to the bio brand version in all ways, especially the strength, route of administration, bioequivalence, etc. So the label has to be similar. Then module 2 is common technical document summaries. Here we give the summary of all the modules, coming modules such as module 3, 4 and 5. So a summary should be there, and overall CTD content should be there, then summary of all the documents that is included in module 3, 4 and 5. So how it is has to be prepared, it is given in the M4, organization of the CTD. Then module 3 is the quality. So this also, there is table of content, data and also literature reference. So this, for this they can refer to the M4Q or the CTD quality, and all the information that is supporting the quality of the particular product can be included here. And the literature references also can be included, and they have to ensure that each of the document is separated by a binder or a tab. It has to be separately bounded, or some identifier should be there so that they can understand it is a different document. Then module 4 is non-clinical, which is not required for ANDA. Then clinical study reports shall be included. So clinical study reports of the brand as well as the ANDA, sorry, as well as the generic version has to be available, especially the generic versions. Bioequivalence study reports, where we submit the reports of the bioequivalence study that is done in healthy volunteers. So around 24 to 36 healthy volunteers will be given the particular drug, and both the generic and the brand will be compared for like whether the generic version is of the drug is reaching the blood in the specified time after administration, and it has to be similar to that of the brand drug. So that report has to be submitted. Again, here also we can check this, the M4E, CTD efficacy can be referred for filing. Then ANDA's filing checklist is there, like for all the modules, they can, especially for module 5, in the ANDA filing checklist, it is mentioned what all has to be included, that can be referred. Then number of copies, archival copy, review copy and field copy. Then the color code for each of the copies also there. So this is the content and format of the abbreviated new drug application. Abbreviated new drug application is in a way a blessing, because the generic version of the drug is less expensive. So the people especially the people in developing countries can benefit out of it, because the treatment cost, overall treatment cost is reduced. The burden of illness of a nation can be reduced when generic versions of the drugs are marketed. So that is all about the abbreviated neural gap detection. So it is clear.